it's penalties. Jose Wright of Brazil signals that the extra time is over. Paul Gascoigne on his knees. And England move into new territory. Never before has the full England side been involved in a penalty shootout, but I tell you what, there's some sporting gestures going on all over the pitch. Players from each side have got their arms around each other as if to say, well, whatever happens now, we've taken part in a memorable occasion, and you wouldn't really want it settled this way. You certainly wouldn't want to lose it this way. But another time we should debate this, whether the World Cup final teams should both be determined by penalty shootouts is, I have to say, highly debatable. But those are the rules of the competition. It is exciting. And Trevor Brooking, I'm just wondering whether our nerve will hold like Bobby Robson seems to.
Well, whatever happens, it's been a magnificent match. You know, Cameroon-England was probably the best match of the tournament so far, but this has surpassed it easily. It's really had me on the edge of my seat. England have played superb throughout the side. Whatever happens, I mean, I certainly wouldn't like to be taking any of the penalties. I'm sure no one back home would, because it is such a nerve-wracker, as we saw with Italy and Argentina last night. And whoever's nominated, whoever misses on either side, will have everyone's sympathy.
Well, they'll be just working it out now, Trevor, because they have to give the list of penalty takers in the right order to the referee. And I think we may have time now just to catch our breath and see what life's like back in London.
Well, can we all bear it? Peter Shilton's had many fine hours, but this might yet be his finest hour. We'll wait and see. Brian Robson, would you have been one of the penalty takers if you'd been fit and there?
Unfortunately, I would have been.
So you know what these guys will be going through. But the unluckiest man out there must be, Jimmy, must be Gascoigne for that booking it, because if they get through, he's out of the final.
Terribly unfair, and also not because it was a tackle in which he's obviously going for the ball, that he's trying to get his foot through for the ball there, but because the fuss that is made afterwards.
Scandalous.
Look at that. I mean, we have seen that with the Germans before.
Look at the state.
Yeah.
Poor lad.
I should take the camera.
I mean, he's in an awful situation, and we can understand that. Terry, you predicted it, in fact.
I didn't say it happened. I've been really worried in the last couple of days, not through any fault of his own, because the way he's behaved through the games has been immaculate. And that is just unfortunate. I know he's going to be heartbroken over that.
I meant you predicted the tears.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
Poor fella. Anyway, he's had a wonderful World Cup. He's been the hero of it, really.
He's a star, isn't he?
No doubt about it.
He
and he behaved immaculately after it happened, because he could have fallen apart.
Absolutely. Yeah. He'd done really well, because he could have easily lost his
penalties. It is. Penalties it is. John?
Yes, it is, Desmond. And I just wanted to add to that conversation you were having. Bobby Robson did take time out in the heat of the occasion to go up to Paul Gascoigne and console him in the centre circle. And they're still giving their order of penalty takers to the officials. Just run over again what I said earlier on. I know Gary Lineker and Peter Beardsley and Stuart Pearce were nominated to take three of them. I have a feeling that Waddle's name was in the hat somewhere as well. And Bobby Robson and Franz Beckenbauer, did they ever think it would come to this? We're, as I said, for the England team, about to see something we've never seen before. And if somebody had said to me at the start of the World Cup, well, you'll be commentating on a penalty shootout to decide whether or not England play in the final, I must admit, I would have swallowed very hard indeed. But that's what's going to happen. And the long delays which always precede these penalty competitions are partly because the referee and linesman have to be absolutely certain in what order the five kickers from each team are going to step up. And that was proved the other day when Yugoslavia tried to change their players round, were told they couldn't, and promptly missed and went out of the competition. So you've got to be sure what you're doing. And the tactical brains that have already worked overtime in 120 minutes of football, those of Franz Beckenbauer and Bobby Robson, now have to tune into something quite different. Peter Beardsley with time to smile. In fact, I was watching the shootout last night with Peter and Gary Lineker at the hotel, and I don't think any of us really wanted it to finish this way tonight, but we did say half seriously, well, Peter Shilton could be facing them this time tomorrow. And this man mountain of a goalkeeper at 40 years of age on the occasion of his 124th international, the world record already well surpassed, is now being asked to rise to greater heights still. Lothar Matthäus taking instructions from Franz Beckenbauer. Matthäus, who scored from a penalty when Germany beat Czechoslovakia in the quarter-final. Lineker, who scored from two when England beat Cameroon in the quarter-final. So we already have two players on the pitch who know what it's about in this tournament. And it will be interesting to see if those two take the first penalty for each side. I think by now, those of you who've tuned into the World Cup know the situation. They take five kicks each. And it's a question of who scores the most, in simple terms, over those 10 penalties, five for each team. Unless, of course, somebody establishes a completely winning lead in that time. If it was five all, or if it was all square after five each, it goes to a straightforward knockout principle where if somebody misses and somebody scores, then they go through. So the two men at the centre of the drama are the two goalkeepers, Peter Shilton and 23-year-old Bodo Ilgner from Stuttgart. And it looks very much as though England will start, because Ilgner has walked towards the goal and Shilton has walked away. England won a toss for that. And never in the history of England international football has so much hinged on such a shootout. Gary Lineker, whose nerve held so wonderfully well when he took the first one against Cameroon, is now asked to beat the goalkeeper and give his side a lead at the start. And does. No hesitation, no question about the way he shaped up, that Lineker knew he was going to score. He cracked that past Ilgner, who must have seen the penalty the other night, I would think, against the Cameroon, and so maybe Lineker decided to put it in that side. Anyway, it's going to be Brehme now for West Germany. Scores. 1-1. Two very well taken penalties. Brehme found the spot right in the corner of the net, although Shilton went the right way. And Peter Beardsley, brought back into the England team today to take the second one. He has had penalty experience with Liverpool. Just to think, England went 92 games under Bobby Robson without getting a penalty kick. Well over 4 years. And now, after two the other night, they're facing five more today. Beardsley to take the second one. Scores. The goalkeeper tries to make himself as big as possible. He too went the right way, but the height beat him really. Matthäus, the West German captain, out of your picture, has gone forward to take the second kick for his team. He scored, as I said, in the quarter-final. Wonder if Shilton saw where he put it. Well, there was no chance of saving that. It's 2-2, all four converted. Matthäus for Germany. David Platt will take England's third penalty. What a responsibility for him. He wasn't even going to be in the team till a short time ago. Now can he make it 3-2? He can. Well, the goalkeepers are making every effort to save these. They're going the right way. And the kicks are so good, they just can't get to them. This is David Platt making it 3-2 to England, who've got the advantage of going